Hey, what is up? Hello, welcome to or welcome back to my channel. My name is Emma if you're new here, and if you're not new here, then it's great to have you here. Today I am going to be talking to you, well, it's kind of a bit of a story time because I didn't actually vlog the ball. I tried to vlog it last year, it didn't work, so this is where I've ended up again. Also like to apologize in advance for the lighting. I know it is shocking, it is, yeah. But it's currently nearly 7 o'clock, it's winter, it's cold, I have a dressing gown on, my PJs on already. I'm just basically gonna talk you guys through what I did to prepare myself for the ball. Basically gonna talk you through the night as well, like a bit of a story time, because why the heck not? Disclaimer before I get into this, you don't have to do any of this like stuff to prepare for the ball. I am in my last year of high school, so I did want to, you know, make the most of it and make it as enjoyable for myself as I could. Not that, and like, if you didn't do this stuff, like, it wouldn't be enjoyable, but you guys know what I mean. Like, you don't have to go above and beyond to have a good time. First thing that, as a girl, I organized was my dress. So, finding a dress is always a challenge. I mean, if you've been to a ball or any formal event before where you need to find an outfit, you'll know that it is not an easy task. It's just, there's so many choices, and you just need to make sure that you choose one that, you know, it's gonna work for you, it's gonna fit you and stuff. So the first dress I chose, I'll put a photo of it here, that did not fit me, and I got it from America, which was an issue because that meant that I couldn't send it back. So it's actually literally sitting here right in front of me in the plastic bag. I need to try and sell it. So then I had to go to plan B, which was another dress that I saw that I liked, which I'll link down below, and obviously you'll see it in the photos, which was from Hello Molly, and that was, I think it was like $70 or something, which was an absolute steal. I was very happy with that. And it was a very simple dress. I didn't want to be drawing any unnecessary attention to myself or anything like that, so I was happy with it. But the only problem with that dress was that the straps over the shoulder were like too long. It just didn't sit right on my body. So I got both the straps taken in by like a, what are they called? A seamstress. And she fixed it up for me. I think that was like $30 to get it fixed. But it was worth the $30 to make sure I was comfortable on the night, obviously. And then as far as actual preparation as far as myself goes for the ball, so the ball was on the Saturday night, so that started on the Monday prior to the ball. I know you're probably thinking this is absolutely extreme, like, especially if you're a dude watching this, you're probably like, okay, this is ridiculous. But I started with getting my eyebrows waxed and tinted, and then eyelashes tinted too. So as you can see, I got my glasses on. That's that, because I don't wear makeup, so I like to have my brows tinted like every 8 weeks anyway. So it had been 8 weeks, so I got them done anyway, but it just so happened that that would be around the time of the ball, which worked perfectly. And then straight after that appointment on the same day, so I had school and then the brow appointment, and then I went on to get my hair done. It had been a year since I last got highlights put through it, and I didn't want to go fully blonde again, so I just got blonde, as you can see, is very, very prominent at the front of my hair. And you can see it, if I pull it back, there's like highlights going through on either side. So I got that done as well. And then I got a cut as well because my hair was looking a bit manky at the ends. So that was that. And then fast forward to Thursday, so about 48 hours out from the ball, I did my fake tan. But I used the Loving Tan Deluxe Bronzing Mousse. And I mean, I've tried other tanning products, like I don't want to bag anyone out, but from what I've tried, Loving Tan is by far my favorite fake tan, because it just doesn't smell. Like, you know, if you've used fake tan before, you know that it has like the smell. Like you know what I mean. I like using Loving Tan because it doesn't have that smell, because honestly that smell makes me gag a little bit. Fast forward to Saturday morning, so morning of the ball, I had netball in the morning, so I couldn't get fake nails professionally put on, but I did use some of the Kiss, hang on, I have them. So I just used these Kiss gel fantasy nails, which are the press-on ones, which they work great once you get the hang of it. But I am brain smart, but I'm not street smart, so putting these on for me was quite the challenge. The nails are like, come obviously, as you can see here, in different sizes. So I got all the sizes, laid them all out perfectly, and then you get little stickers which are like double-sided tape kind of, and you stick it on and then you peel it off and then you put the nail on and you press it down and it sticks, which is great. Except I would start with this hand and I did all these four upside down.
Oh no.
Yeah, so as you can see, the glitter is supposed to be at the fingertip, but I decided that apparently the glitter had to go at the cuticle end of my nail. Because the thing was, I put them on, like, these are really uncomfortable. And then I looked at the picture, I was like, yeah, I would put them on back to front. So I had to then pull those four nails off and make use, because it comes with 24 stickers. Obviously, you don't have 24 fingernails, so I just used some of the stickers from the other size nails. So that was cool. And then to add to that, I then had to go to my appointment to curl my hair for the ball. I was going to have it straight, but I wanted something different because, you know, got to change it up a little bit. This nail here was, like, coming off, like, falling off. I was like, oh, I'll just press it down like a little stick, it'll be fine. And I got to my hair appointment, and then it just completely fell off. I was like, oh, that's sick. I have to glue that one back on when I get home. And then I was sitting there when she was doing my hair, and I peeled off, like, the sticky thing, and I hadn't peeled off the other side, like, the double-sided sticker, so it was literally just sitting there the whole time, so I peeled that off and stuck it back on, and it was fine. So that was that. So then, obviously I got my hair curled. My hair isn't naturally straight, like, I do straighten it. In saying that, it doesn't hold a curl very well. It holds waves, but not curls. And then straight after, I went to get my makeup done, which I got done at my work because I work at a pharmacy. So one of the lovely ladies there, she did my makeup for me, and she did it last year as well. Most makeup artists ask you what look you want, and I have no idea because I don't wear makeup, and I just don't know what to ask for. I don't know what looks good. I don't know any of the terminology or anything. So I was like, you know what, just do whatever you think will look good. So after that, I had to head home and get changed into my dress and put my jewelry on and things. So I'll link all my jewelry and things down below. It's literally just like my everyday jewelry, except I swap my sleepers here out for these earrings, because the theme of our ball was diamonds are forever. So these were, like, you know, as close as I could get to diamonds on the fact that I'm poor. Yeah, and I just wore, like, my everyday rings and then my necklace. My boyfriend came with me as, like, my date for the ball, and then we went to my grandparents and got photos and things before we went to the pre-ball. So now we get to the pre-ball. So this was with most of the people from my year. It was hosted by one of the people in my year who's one of my close friends from back in the day. From there we caught party buses to the venue where the ball was held. You could have caught the school buses, but we were just like, you know what, we're gonna catch a party bus. So that was pretty cool. It was basically just like a normal bus with some LED strip lighting and an aux cord. We had Canon music, and that was great. So basically this brings us to the ball itself. So if you haven't been to a ball before, basically it's a chance to dress up nice, take some photos, dance around. Basically, when we went in, the theme was obviously Diamonds Are Forever, which is James Bond 007. And we all sat down, like, found a table. So they started to take photos. Like, you could go, like, and have different backdrops and things. You can take photos with your friends. Photo booth set up as well. And then most people just hit the dance floor, to be honest. The DJ that we had was insane. It was literally like a mosh pit, and there's, like, strobe lights and confetti cannons, and it was a good time. Partway through the evening, we have dinner and desserts. The music stops, and they put on, like, other music. And then after that, we had the youth eating dance, which I might insert a small clip of. Right.
In the crib, mom, drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot, drop it like it's hot. Yeah.
one thing I will say, if you are going to a ball, lots of formal events like that have a rule where you can't walk around barefoot just for like health and safety reasons. So take flat shoes. I took my Converse and I rocked those from 9:30 till the ball finished at like 11:30 p.m. So that was great. So at 11:30, the ball kind of winds up. So we went home in the school buses. And then most people went to an after ball. I didn't. I came home and slept. It was literally like the best night. And just to be like dressed up and oh, it's so much fun. So if you have a school ball, don't hesitate going. It's literally so much fun. This ball was a lot different to my one last year, and that this year I spent a lot more time on the dance floor as opposed to in the photo area, to the point where when we left I didn't have a voice left because I was like screaming and yelling and singing and stuff on the dance floor. Like, it was so good. But yeah, that's my story of the ball. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already, because I'd love to have you around here. It's free, we really love that. Yeah, socials are always linked down below, as well as all my equipment and things. Always asking me my equipment and where I'm from and things, but it's all down in the description bar. All you have to do is click that little see more button and all your questions will be answered. But thank you guys so much for watching. It makes one smile, and I'll see you guys next week for yet another video. I just said eyebrows twice.